Hi, I'm Tim Whitt, and welcome to another Let's Mod, where I attempt all of the modifications online to see if they work so that you don't have to. Today we're doing a quick one where I'm going to be trying to put a decal onto a guitar scratch plate to pimp it up a little bit. I've searched a couple of different places online, and what I've found was that some DIY places recommend either using transparencies or a tracing paper or freezer paper if you really want to go ghetto on it. I took the design down to my local Office Works where they printed it onto overhead transparencies and what they call tracing paper. So I got this design online. It's this sweet chandelier. The artist's signature appears to be Pagel, so please give them some respect. What I've attempted so far is using some oomph stain remover, which would sort of destabilize the ink and then allow it to be transferred onto the sheet. These are my results so far. I've tried that, and then I tried ironing it, which has actually yielded the best results. I tried ironing the transparency sheets, which, okay, I had much more luck with the tracing paper, so that's what I'm going to go with. I'm going to, instead of using the oomph stain remover, I'm going to just attempt to do like an iron-on transfer onto a t-shirt. So, one thing to be careful about is have your iron set to a low setting. I had mine on a high setting and I actually warped the scratch plate. It turned into like a rubber in my hands. So I was able to quickly stack a book on top of it to get it to chill out again. But that's something to watch out for. So here I go. Let's find out. Okay, so I've got my design stuck down. Make sure you mirror the design first on the back, because you're going to be printing on, essentially, by sticking the face down, ironing it on, so the image needs to be in reverse on the paper. So, I got it stuck down, I got my towel down so I don't burn the table. Got my iron set to low, set to steam off. All right, come on, baby. I am lightly concerned about melting the sticky tape, which is holding my sheet down. But that's the risks we take. Alright, it doesn't seem to be doing anything yet with my iron at low temperature. Very lightly transferring the ink off of the print. Very lightly. I don't know whether to keep at it. My scratch plate is starting to warp already. It seemed to straighten back out again without too much hassle last time, so I'm hoping to experience the same luck again. Okay. Starting to get more transfer. I'm going to crank it up just a touch. I'm going to set it to silk. Look at that action. You're watching the ironing channel. Non-stop ironing. 24 hours a day. Something I found with the using the stain remover was that the ink would smudge a lot, so the stain remover would get into the ink and sort of erode it, and then as I pressed down on the back of the paper it would sort of squeeze out a bit and smudge, so that was not a desirable result. This one seems to be working better in that it isn't smudging and running, it's just going on clean. Although, if you look at it, there's a little bit, you can see how floppy and bendy my scratch plate is now. Alright, I've left some books on it to keep it pressed down and flat while it chills out. It's pretty cool now, the plastic is more solid once again. Let's peel it off and see what we have. Easy does it. That's not bad. It's kind of giving it like a faded, slightly distressed, kind of like vintage vibe, like when you go and buy, say, pre-faded t-shirts. That's pretty cool. And like that is on there pretty solidly. Yeah, giving it a good scratch there, like what you'd do with your pick guard, like with your pick, and that's not coming off. So I bought some clear lacquer for it, but it doesn't look like I'll need it. So I just should point out that I used a laser printer for this. They got laser printers at Office Works. I don't think it will work with the inkjet. So yeah, there you go. Will it mod? Yeah, pretty much. Good luck.